Hello everybody, welcome to Maintain Me. I am Desiree.
And I'm Morgan.
And today we're gonna talk about how to find a senior living community when moving from another state. It's a lot to take on, it's overwhelming, so we just wanna walk through some good steps to take. We can spend 20, 30 minutes talking about this.
Yes, for sure.
But we just wanna highlight some good bullet points on what to do first and what to do next. So number one, you know, first thing you need to do is find your local agent, and you can do that through the MPRA directory online, and we can actually set a link for that down in the comments below, so you know exactly where to go.
Maybe tell them what the MPRA is.
How about I let you do that,
Mark? Okay, I'll do that. So as Desiree mentioned, the first thing you can do when looking for an agent, a local agent in another state, when you are looking for a senior living community, is to reference the National Placement Referral Alliance database and website. It's a list of all the local agents in each state. Also, it'll make a note if you're certified. So if you're a certified placement referral agent, so there's contact information in there. And that's a great place to start. Then you can go and Google and search them and find more information on that particular agency or that particular person. But that's the first place I would go if I were living in another state and I was looking to, say, move to Colorado, back near the kids, what have you. I would go look at the NPRA, National Placement Referral Alliance, check the link down below, and pick an agent from there. And then you get into the deciding factors.
Yes, the deciding factors. You know, a cost of living, what does that look like, what you could afford? Depending on your state, it's going to vary really from one end of the spectrum to the other end of the spectrum. So cost of living, what you could afford, what's going to be financially responsible for you.
Well, that's a great way to put that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you don't want to be house poor, nope. No matter what, in senior living or of course, if you're buying regular real estate. So the second thing is support systems. So maybe you're moving to be near family. Maybe you're moving to be near friends. Maybe you've done your research, and if you're living in, say, California or New York or some of the more expensive states, and you notice that something in the Midwest is going to be more affordable, for your long-term living goals, mm-hmm. especially if you have a chronic disease that may need help in the future, you may need help with your activities of daily living, making sure to look at what support systems are available in and above your senior living community are really important. Parkinson's groups, for instance, maybe MS support groups, or having a local chapter of support if you have diabetes or something else that would really give you support if you don't have family or friends there, and it'd be a way for you to meet new people in your new state.
So, exactly. Yeah. And going with that hand in hand is types of care, the different communities, what they have to offer and what's available. And to go into a little bit more in detail is, are you looking for independent living, and does that independent living offer communities to come in that provide home health care or home care for you, you know, here and there? You don't need it every day, but you do need it at some point. Or if you're looking for an assisted living, what's their level of care look like? So if you are coming from out of state and you do have ALS, can they provide that level of care for you in an assisted living setting? And if you need a continuum care community that kind of houses all of it, you know, independent living, assisted living, and skilled nursing level of care, you're really looking down the road and being proactive instead of reactive. And along with that is, what does their availability look like? Because depending on the season, at least here in Colorado, you know, everybody loves to move in the summer. Who doesn't love to move in the summer? Yeah. Nobody wants to move while it's snowing, especially in Colorado.
Yeah.
So, you know, do they have availability for your time frame for when you're looking to move? It's really important to, you know, get those facts in order so you can make the most appropriate, responsible decision.
Yeah. Awesome. The next the next deciding factor is what type of insurance is available. Mm-hmm. So, for instance, maybe you are Medicare, but maybe you have a supplement through United, or, you know, I just read today that Friday Health Plans in Colorado is going to be shutting down. So if you have a certain insurance that maybe is a smaller or state specific, if you move to another state, is that insurance honored, or will you have to switch it? Because then you'll have to take that into consideration when you're making that move. Is, do they have Kaiser, or, you know, mm-hmm. depending upon what it is, there's so many different options out there. But then would you need to find a broker? So what other resources would you need if your insurance does not transfer?
Exactly. Another deciding factor is location, environment. Colorado is such a beautiful place to live, and you can live in the foothills next to the mountains with hiking trails, or you can move out east to the plains where there's farmland and open space. It's really deciding what's going to work best for you, not only the environment but physically. If you have, you know, if you're using a walker or if you're using a wheelchair,
great point.
Yeah, yeah, you know, what's going to be more beneficial for you and give you that quality of life. Location, location, location. I think that's what all realtors say.
That is.
It is.
But it's still true.
It's still true. Even in this time of your life, looking for a senior community, location is key, because you also got to be close to your support system. So if you're moving here for friends and or for family, how close are they to the community you have your eyes set on? Mm-hmm. So if anything was to happen, they're close by.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Mm-hmm. And then another deciding factor is what other services are offered. Mm-hmm. So maybe you're on a pretty tight income, or your budget is pretty tight, and you're younger. So is there Medicaid offered in every state has it, but not every community takes it. So what does that look like for you? Are you going to need in the future to rely on a government program, and does the community that you're looking at accept that? And so we started this, I'm going to just circle back here real quick because I think it's important. Mm-hmm. We started this whole conversation by saying get a local agent. And the reason we did that is because when you're looking in a different state, you need an expert that is in that state. And what that expert is going to do is look at all of these factors. How much does it cost? Where is it? What's the environment like? You could get online, look at a community. Oh my gosh, it's beautiful. Yeah. Look at it's so perfectly manicured and landscaped, but turns out that's just this little tiny pocket right at the community, and then the rest of it is all dirt roads around it. So you want someone local who's gonna say, did you know there's dirt roads that surround that whole community, so your walks aren't gonna be very substantial if you need to use an assistive device. That's the kind of intel, that's the kind of beta a local agent will help you get. So that's why we said that first and then went into the deciding factors, of course.
Exactly. And that local agent is going to set up those tours. And because you're out of state, it's going to be virtual tours. And so tours and how to choose and what, you know, what platform to use for virtual tours, because not everybody is tech savvy. So that's what we do. We help you figure that out. We get it going. We're your boots on the ground, if you say. And then we look at state survey results, family referrals. Are there current residents that are friends with your, you know, friends that live here in state, or family members? You know, getting that word of mouth referral to you is so important. And again, like Morgan said, that's what we are here to help you do. Boots on the ground, eyes physically on the community, yes, and what's surrounding, and helping you go through those state surveys. Because at the end of the day, it's what's going to matter to you, what's important to you. And that's how that's we help point. Break down that long list of communities that you've chosen, and get your top three, your top four, and set up those tours for you. Because you're not here, we'll do them for you. Hand in, you know, phone in hand, and walking around and looking through the cabinets. It's really what we love to do to help you make that decision, that, you know, more responsible decision, because it's hard.
It is hard. Mm-hmm. And one other, you know, some agencies, I guess we can't speak for everybody, but in speaking for Maintain Me, all of us have a clinical background. While we're not clinicians, licensed clinicians, Chelsea, the owner obviously is, but we have that background, so we can have a pretty in-depth conversation with you or with your loved one, if you would need help or support with that, to really narrow and drill down what your needs are going to look like and what's the most appropriate level of care. So we can be very succinct with your time and not showing you anything that doesn't make sense for your needs, for your desires. Mm-hmm. Like Desiree said, what's more important to you? So you get the benefit of our experience, our vast experience, combined with knowing the area very well to help you make an informed decision even a few states away.
Exactly. So if you have any questions or if you want more information about this, please reach out. We'd be so happy to help you. You can put a comment, you can call us. Our number's on the website here. But that's it for us today.
Hit the subscribe button. So you'll know when we post new videos.
Yes, always informative. And that's what we aim for, is to bring education to you. So if you have a question and we have not covered it, put it down below in the comments. We'd love to help you out and answer any questions you have.
Yep. Thanks for watching today. Have a good one. Bye-bye.